If you're like me, you've probably been active your entire life. Now, there are times when my knee barks at me, my right knee will bark at me a little bit. So on those days, I skip the lunges and squats that I might do in my workout. And instead, the Romanian deadlift, or RDL, is an excellent exercise with many benefits. Let me give you a few pointers about it. Number one, I'm doing the RDL with two kettlebells, but you can do it with dumbbells, you can do it with barbells, you can do it with any type of weight. But the thing is, if you're holding a dumbbell, if you're holding a kettlebell, holding a barbell, you want to grip it as tight as possible. Your grip strength is actually connected to the muscles that stabilize your spine. So the tighter you squeeze the grip, the more stability we get out of the spine. Now, an important point about this exercise is we're not moving from the spine. The spine stays straight throughout the exercise. I'm going to give you a side view. During the RDL, the spine stays straight. We move from the hips. You want to keep your knees slightly bent, and as you lean forward, push your hips back. That's one mistake I see people make. As you drop your chest down, push your weight back into your hip. Here's a little trick. To go back, push your hips back. As you come up, push your hips forward, but pull your knees back at the same time. So we come down, and then we come up, push those hips forward, and pull the knees back. So here's the thing. Our adductors, our inner thigh muscles, and our hamstrings attach to the back of the femur. So when we come up, if we think about pulling those knees back, if we slide those knees back on the way up, what we're doing is we're engaging those posterior chain muscles, the adductors and hamstrings, to be a little bit more effective. Because the adductors and hamstrings attach along the back of the femur, the back of the thigh bone, as you come up, push your feet into the ground and think about sliding your knees back. So push the feet down, slide the knees back. Another trick for the RDL is as you come up, think about the body, your bottom of your pelvis. The muscles, your hamstrings attach right at the bottom of your pelvis. So as you come up, think about pulling the bottom of your shorts or the bottom of your pelvis closer to your back of your thighs. So as you come up, think about pulling your pelvis down. That's technically called the ischial tuberosity. The bottom of your pelvis is the ischial tuberosity, but think right along the bottom of your bum or right along the bottom of your underwear. You want to pull the bottom of your underwear closer to the back of your thighs. So that's the trick for doing the RDL. You go down, keep the knees bent. As you come up, pull your knees back and rotate your pelvis down. So come up, slide those knees back and rotate the pelvis down. When you do that, when you think about pulling those knees back and you think about rotating that pelvis down, you're using all those muscles and engaging them from both the bottom and the top to make it a full leg workout. Not only will you feel it here in your glutes, but you also feel it along the back of your thighs. That's exactly what you want. To learn more about core training, pick up a copy of my book, Smarter Workouts, The Science of Exercise Made Simple.